right? I'll just be a few minutes and I'll be out of your face, and I want to share from Proverbs 18 verse 16, and it says, a man's gift maketh room for him and bringeth him before great men. A man's gift maketh room for him and bringeth him before great men. We grew up in our African society to believe, and I don't know how that perception came, but we grew up and we were taught to believe that when you're born, you go to school, you come out of school. When you come out of school, you get a job. When you get a job, you get all the opportunities that you need. And from those opportunities, you begin to get room made for you. And so all of us, even in this generation, mostly seated here today, have been taught to believe that when you go to school and come out, the next thing you should do is look for a job. Fortunately or unfortunately, in the present day that we live in, looking for a job has become as hard as looking for oil in Bauchi State. You know, so they're not looking for oil in Bauchi for a long time now. We've not seen, they are still looking for. They are building refinery in advance for when they will see the oil. So looking for a job today is like that. Many of us here as young people have graduated from school, some of us with fantastic degrees, first degree, second degree, we've gotten some came out with a 2-1, some came out with a 2-2, some came out with whatever degrees you came out with. You came out and they told you that based on the fact that you are from the Niger Delta area, somewhere, somehow, you will get a job in the oil industry. And you have applied and applied and applied. Some of you went to banks, oil companies, and all the other places to apply for jobs, to the extent that we started applying for jobs that are not in the area of what we study, but all in the bid to get a job. We just started applying because we were told that once you go to school and come out, you get a job. What I come to tell you differently today from what is in this book of Proverbs, where it says that it is your gift that will make room for you, and it didn't mention anything about a job. Says a man's gift to make room for him. Many of us have giftings and talents today that God gave to us, even at our point of birth, but the problem is that we have not been able to recognize those giftings. Many of us have recognized our own giftings, but we feel that that gifting is not good enough. It's too small. So your gifting is that you know how to make hair. Some of you, your gifting is that you know how to talk. Some of you, your gifting is that you know how to cook. Some of us, we know how to decorate. So we become internal decorators or party planners and all of that. Some of us that know how to do makeup designs, but become big makeup artists. But some of you that are into other things that you see as, oh, this is small. Now only small children as we take care of. We have grown to the extent where we have now commonized our giftings and talents that we have not used them for anything else. So you feel that not only I only sabi take care of small children. Who told you that that's a waste? You can take care of small children. There are people who are looking for people who will take care of their small children when they're not around. There are schools who are looking for people who will help them take care of small children. In these days, you find out that many people you see who are taking care of small children, they do that because they do not have a passion for it, but because they just need the money. If you do it with your passion, you will do it better. If you do it as a gifting, you will do it better. And where I am today, by the grace of God, I got to this position, I got to this point because I was walking in line with my gifting and passion. I like to talk to the extent that when I was in primary school, even though I had a sleep, they write my name for noisemaker. Talk, every time. So then when I had a sleep for class, they don't write my name for number one. You know, you get those kind of people, they write their name. So this guy, if you wake, you go talk, no need, we'll just write his name down. And you know how it is for a young man who talks very much, they will beat you. Keep quiet. Talk up your mouth. You talk too much. For those of you, when they beat you, actually, when they talk, it's not good though. Eh? You can control him from talking, but find out, what if that is what God gave him as a gift and a talent? Now everybody's a bit talk. So just day the house. Day there. Morning to night. How are you? You not talk anything. What is happening to you? You not talk. Now my own, I talk at the talk. From primary school come, I got into university. I talk so day when I enter association for school, they put me as PRO. I enter SUG, now the same thing they put me. When I got out, I discovered that I like to talk. So what can I get from this talking to you? Can you imagine? If I just talk where I like to talk and I can get money from you, it don't make sense. That thing when you do now is that people can go see soup, is that people can wash soup. Everybody want to cook a war, they can't look for you. Imagine that you are cooking that whole soup and they are paying you money for it. Living in your gifting and your talents.